Knowing how many people to recruit for qualitative research studies can be tricky. In quantitative studies, you can perform a power calculation to gain a suggested sample size. In qualitative research, this is not possible. That's because the aim of qualitative research is not to generalize numbers to represent the broader population or to compare numbers. Instead, in qualitative research, we're looking to gain an understanding of a phenomenon, such as a user behavior or human experience, and why it occurs. So, how do we know how many people we need for a qualitative study? The right number of participants for a qualitative study is the number that gets you close to something called saturation. Saturation can be described as the point where the returns on what you're learning diminish. When you've hit saturation, each extra research session produces less new information. As more sessions are added, you'll likely hear or see the same thing happening more frequently. Several factors can affect how large the sample needs to be to reach saturation or to get close to it. Let's look at three of the biggest factors. The first factor is how diverse your target population is. If the people you are looking to recruit come from many different backgrounds, geographic regions and cultures, or exhibit many different behaviors, then you'll need to recruit more people to reach saturation. Unlike, say, a study that is focused on a particular group, say people who all work in the same role or industry. One way to limit your sample size for a qualitative study is to focus on a particular segment. The second factor is your research scope. This relates to your research goals and how broad or specific they are. Broad goals, like learning about people's mental models around taxation, would require more participants to reach saturation. Compared to a more scoped research goal, like learning what the biggest pain points are for people when filing their taxes. The third big factor that can affect the sample size needed for saturation is how skilled the researcher is. An experienced researcher often extracts more information from participants in a moderated research session by using pointed follow-up questions. Since more data is collected in these sessions, there's a greater likelihood of patterns emerging earlier. Since it's hard to know in advance how many participants are needed for a qualitative research study ahead of time, it's best to start small and analyze as you go. Often, we learn enough after a small number of users to take the next step, which is why we recommend recruiting 5 users per round of usability testing. Regardless of the method, start by recruiting 5 to 6 participants. After each session, debrief with your team. Are you learning new information? Are you hearing the same thing? If you feel you haven't sampled who you need, or you're still learning new things, recruit 1 or 2 more participants and review again. Remember that qualitative studies don't require large samples, and there are diminishing marginal returns with each extra session added. So, use your time wisely. It's better to run smaller studies often than large, complicated studies infrequently.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.